You hear everywhere on social media and the interweb that the first thing you need to do for your adoption is to start your home study, right? In this video, I am gonna give you three reasons why doing your home study first will actually hurt you in the long run. For the best adoption advice, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell button to be notified when I post a new video every week. For those of you who are new to my channel, welcome. I am so glad you're here. My name is Lacrice Bundy. I am an adoption lawyer, and let's get into it. So I hear from so many first-time hopeful adoptive parents who want to grow their family through adoption, and usually they've already started their home study, so they're in the process of doing that, or they've already scheduled a meeting with the caseworker to come and start their home study. And so when I ask them, okay, great, like what type of adoption are you pursuing? They give me this crazy look like, what do you mean? I want to adopt a child. So here's the first reason why you should not do your home study first, okay? Your home study is tailored to the type of adoption that you're looking to do. So if you just call an agency to get your home study done, and then a few months later you change your mind about the type of adoption you want to pursue, most likely you're going to have to redo your home study. So what you want to do instead is narrow down the type of adoption that you want to pursue. Do you want to pursue a newborn adoption in your state or outside of your state? Do you want to do an international adoption? Do you want to adopt a child from foster care in your state or out of your state that's, you know, ready to be adopted right now? Or do you want to foster first and then hopefully adopt? Once you get clear on the type of adoption you want to do, then you're ready to start your home study. But before then, make sure that you got that narrowed down so that you're not wasting your time or your money. So do you know the type of adoption that you want to pursue? Comment below and let me know. So reason number two, you could lose a lot of your money unnecessarily. Private adoption agencies are privately owned. This means that they're independent agencies who set up their own rules internally about how they do their adoptions. Of course, they have to follow the law, right, of the state that they're licensed in. But what I mean is that just internally and how they go about doing the adoption, they can set up their own internal rules. So what can happen is that if you go to private adoption agency A and you go there to get your home study done, and then let's say a few months later, you're like, man, I don't really like them. They were really awesome when I first called them, but now nobody's calling me back. I want to try a different agency. So let's say now you go to private adoption agency B. Agency B can tell you, well, we can't accept your home study from agency A. You have to do a home study from our own agency. Why? Because they can set up their own rules. They can decide whether they'll accept a home study approved and done by another agency or not because they're privately owned. And there goes $1,500 or more that you just spent on your home study. If any of you have encountered that, please comment below and let me know. Reason number three, some agencies just don't play well with other agencies. Okay, so let's take the example of you maybe wanting to adopt a child in foster care who's ready to be adopted. You want to adopt that child from out of your state. Okay, so you live in Michigan, you want to adopt a foster kid from Virginia, for example, okay? And let's say that you decide to go through Michigan to get your home study done, right? You go through your state to get that done. Then you contact Virginia and you say, hey, this is the child that I found on your website that I would like to adopt. Well, Virginia can decide, well, we don't like your home study from Michigan. We want you to go through a private adoption agency in Michigan to get your home study done. And again, if you do all of that work first and then find out later that they won't accept your home study just because they don't play well together, again, there goes $1,500 or more that you just spent on your home study. Now you have to redo the whole thing. So what I usually suggest to do is whatever state you want to adopt that foster child from, you want to call them up first and hear from them what the rules are about your home study. Okay, do they prefer that you do your home study through your state's foster care agency? Do they prefer that you do it through a private adoption agency? Do they care either way? So that way, when you do get your home study done, you know that it's actually going to be accepted by the place that you're going. And this goes back again to reason number one, which is you need to know the type of adoption that you want to pursue first before you even start figuring out what agency to use to prepare your home study for you. So now you know why you shouldn't do your home study first, the three reasons why actually doing your home study first will hurt you in the long run. Now, if you want to start your adoption on the right foot and you want to do it the right way, click the link below in the description box to find out how you can get started. And guys, I am so excited that my channel is growing so quickly because of all of you who are subscribing And thank you for liking the videos. Thank you for sharing it. I want to know from you guys what adoption topics you want to hear from me. Okay, so please post that in the comments below. And I would love to start making videos to really answer your questions. Now, if you like this video, make sure that you hit that like button. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and share with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye.